practicing the service of priesthood. And I thank God that we are going, we are about the ordination of a new priest and the subject about priesthood. Chapter 9. Aaron had Haman's sons 4. And just being ordained to serve as the ministers to God's people. So it is a service. The ordination service had lasted for 7 days. Now, the moment for which Aaron and his sons had longed was here. The ordained priests were ready to conduct their very first worship service. Picture the people also. We will see in just a moment that everyone, all 2 to 4 million of the Israelites, surrounded the tabernacle. They were all eager to worship the Lord, being filled with the excitement and expectation. I'm trying to give you a picture. The people now had priests for the first time, ordained priests. Ministers of God who would intercede with God for them. The people were now to share in the very first worship service to be held in the worship center, the tabernacle. The priests, newly ordained, were to conduct their very first worship service for the people. What would the priests do? What would be the focus of their message? What would be the order of service? This is very important to think about it. How would the service flow? Imagine the questions flowing through the minds of the people. The priests were to prepare to meet God. Because as I told you before, the priests, they have double service. Facing the people, they talk with the people about the word of God. Standing to pray, they intercede. They ask God for their people. Through the sin offering, seeking forgiveness of sins, we ask the forgiveness of sins. And then the New Testament also. Our Lord Jesus Christ and the Gospel of St. John, chapter 20, he raised into the face of his holy disciples and told them, if you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you repent the sins of any, they are repented. Through the burnt offering, seeking atonement. Atonement in Arabic, al-kafara. Reconciliation with God. Reconciliation with God. The atonement is very important subject, and the reconciliation. The people were to prepare to meet God, Leviticus 9:3-4. And for us in the New Testament, St. Paul told us in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, when you come to take communion, examine yourself. Be ready prepare yourself. We prepare ourselves through fasting, through repentance and confession. When we come and we are ready, we don't have conflict with anyone. We have reconciliation. We prepare ourselves. Through the sin offering, seeking forgiveness of sins, we know that all of us are sinners, asking the forgiveness of our sins. This is why we repeat all the time, Lord, have mercy. Saint John, in his first epistle, says, if we say that we don't have sin, we are liars. Because no one has no sin, even his life is one day on earth. Through the burnt offering, seeking atonement, reconciliation, through the fellowship offering, seeking to grow in fellowship with God. Koinonia. Thanksgiving. Through the green offering, giving thanks to God for the atonement, showing their devotion and the dedication to God. The strange fire. Drama, chapter 3. The judgment of God upon the false worship by two priests, Nadab and Abihu. God has no favoritism. And I note that in the beginning of any service, it is too strict. Because there is no compromise. This is young priesthood. They offered strange fire. I remember this and Achan, son of Carmi, the book of Joshua chapter 7. After the people of Israel, they entered into the promised land. And they entered into Jericho. And God told them not to take anything from Jericho. And this man, he stole and hid it. And he says, no one sees me. And I remember in the book of Acts, Praxeas, chapter 5, Ananias and Sapphira, they lied and they died. They cheated. They had a hypocrisy. They offered the part as the whole price of the field, of the farm. They wanted to look holy and righteous, same as Saint Barnabas. They lied to the Holy Spirit. And they died. Ananias and Sapphira, here, Nadab and Abihu. And I want you to think about Aaron. They are his sons. Two of them died in the beginning. The fate of all who approach God in a wrong way. The judgment of God is a forgotten subject. And some people, they forget. Like Korah, Dathan, Abiram. Like Uzziah, the king. There is little fear of God in the world today. think about it and look around you in the world. Sometimes they talk about that without any respect. Most people deny, reject, and ignore the judgment of God. Once I read about Ananias and Sapphira in the book of Acts chapter 5, and it said that the punishment against the devil himself. Because St. Peter told Ananias, why the devil filled your heart? Because the church faced persecution from outside, but trying now to come from inside, inward, not outward. He failed through persecution. Thank you. Thank you so much. He failed through persecution. So he wants to use some members of the church as tools, as instruments. And this, it makes us to think. This is why our homework today, the epistle of St. Paul, what is the number of the apostles? 12, Hebrews 12. Discipline. And to give me your opinion about the discipline in the church. And discipline in general. Do we do this with our own children? Discipline? Yes? Yes?
Sure.
We should. Should. Do you do it in the as a teacher? Should. Sure. St. Paul said, if you are without discipline, it means that you are not children. Discipline. Hebrews 12. And I will take the paper together. Mm-hmm. The thoughts of judgment and fear of God are considered by some to be unhealthy, even the cause of some neurosis and the psychosis among nurtured people. There is the feeling that what needs to be stressed among the society is only the love and forgiveness of God, not the judgment of God. When we talk about mercy of God, we talk about justice of God. God who is merciful, he is just. On the eighth day of the priest's ordination, fire came down and the people were filled with joy amidst the divine glory as if they were in paradise. But Nadab and Abihu, Aaron's sons, brought grief on the congregation by offering a strange fire, most probably during drunkenness. Most of the scholars, they said that they were drunk, Nadab and Abihu. Therefore, the law forbids the priests from drinking wine in the tabernacle after they were divinely disciplined. It is mentioned in the same chapter, 10:8-9. The scholar says, why here forbid them to drink? Because what had happened? This chapter illustrated the characteristics of the ministers, of the servants, complete obedience to God, Aaron has two sons that disobeyed God. Obedience, listen. We imitate our Lord Jesus Christ according to Philippians chapter 2 from 5 to 11. Emptying himself and he obeyed. Kenosis. Non-drinking of wine and intoxicants in order to distinguish between the holy and the unholy, the purified and the pure, and so that the priest does not lose his ability to teach the divine commandment to the people. This is written by Origen. Origen, the scholar, he was born 185 AD in Alexandria, Egypt. They call him the teacher of the bishops. Origen. They call him the prince of the interpreters of the Holy Book. Origen. Origen, they call him Dean Teen. He was the dean of the school of Alexandria while he was a teenager. Dean Teen. And the school of Alexandria at this time, it was like one of the biggest universities now, because it had the library of Alexandria, which it had about 600,000 of manuscripts. So he said, the high priest and his two sons represent Christ, his disciples and apostles. When these approach the cross, thank God today is the feast of the cross, they don't drink the joyful wine, but remain seeking the redemption of mankind. The Lord offers his blood as an atonement. Meanwhile, the apostles and the disciples offer their lives as witnesses and the preaching for the redemption of the world, so that when the eternal kingdom of God is declared, the Lord drinks with them anew, when perfect eternal joy is achieved by crowning the Holy Church and attaining the participation in the glory of her groom. Let us imitate Aaron's two sons, serving the Lord in sadness because of the perishing of others, until they enjoy sharing us the inheritance. The scholar, Saint Jerome, said that Origen wrote about 3,000 books. I continue and I will bring you print out the next time. Say it again. The book of Leviticus, how many chapters? 27. Divided into two parts. 1 to 17, sanctification. Sanctification means set apart. 18 to 27, pure holiness. 1 to 7 is talking about sacrifices. 8 to 10, priesthood. 8, the ordination. 9, the service. 10, Nadab and Abihu. We said the first 7 is sacrifices, the first 5 chapters, in order like a burnt offering, male or grain offering, peace offering, sin offering, trespass offering, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, chapter 5. 6 and 7 in general about sacrifices. Chapter 11 to 16, purification. We will talk about 17, 16 is the atonement. 17 is the altar. You know what I'm doing now? It is classification. Dividing the three chapters. This is to lead you to think systematically. Not to mix the chapters together. And to try to remember. To have it in your mind. 18 to 20, a regulation concerning people. It has the marriage and all the regulation concerning people and whom you should to marry and whom you should not to marry and so on. Homosexuality and incest and all this stuff. It is in from 18 to 20. 21, 22, priesthood. Talk about it, the requirements, the characters of the priests, how they should choose them. 18 to 20. Sorry, 18 to 20, regulation concerning people. 21, 22, priests. 23, 24, regulation concerning feasts, seven feasts. 26 to 25 to 27 regulation concerning the promised land, Canaan. So, purification. What animals were clean, could be sacrificed, and could be eaten and unclean. I told you about it, the divided hooves. Do you remember? We talked about it. Yes. San Irenaeus and the rumination. The animal, aquatic creatures, birds, winged insects, reptiles. The animal is not considered clean unless two factors combine. Divided hooves, it has claws, and the rumination. Rumination referring to continuous meditation on God's word. If you look to the word meditation, you will find it rumination. Meditation, to meditate. In the book of Joshua, first Psalm, to meditate. I will tell you about several responsibilities regarding the Holy Scriptures. Our responsibility, we should to read, we should to hear, to understand, to memorize, to apply, to preach, to meditate. To read regularly in order, make time to read. Blessed who read, as this is in the book of Revelation, and to listen. Some of us likes to do. To walk, to practice, to work out, have time, or in the car, please. Most of the phones now, it has the scriptures. Audio. There is app. Audio in different languages. To listen, to read, to hear. To understand the word of God. This needs a time, effort, to read commentaries, to understand. Saint Paul says to his disciple Timothy, understand what I'm saying. Sometimes we use this word when we talk with each other. Do you understand what I mean? To understand. Daniel the prophet said, I understood from the books Philip the Deacon in the book of Acts chapter 8, he asked the Ethiopian eunuch, do you understand what you are reading? He was a minister. And they said, no, I need explanation. I need someone to explain it for me. He is humble man. To read, to hear, to understand, to memorize. And I am stressing out even to our children to memorize just a verse a day. And it was time to memorize a lot. To memorize. In the book of Revelation, it says, blessed who reads, blessed who hears, blessed who memorizes. And to memorize, so you can fight against the devil. With the word of God, with the scriptures. When the devil tempted our Lord Jesus Christ, our Lord answered from the scripture because he memorized. And to apply, to put it in practice. Doing before saying. The two disciples of Emmaus in the Gospel of St. Luke chapter 24, they said that our Lord Jesus was mighty in deed and in words. And St. Luke said in the book of Acts chapter 1, what our Lord Jesus Christ did and said. And the Holy Church Fathers stressed the order, did before said. Of love and to preach and to preach St. Paul talked about it in 1 Corinthians chapter 9. I remember the verse in Arabic saying is it darura mawdu' aliyya fawailun li in kuntu la'awash. There is a necessity for me to preach. And woe to me if I don't do it. Is it darura mawdu' alayhi fawailun li in kuntu la'awash. 1 Corinthians chapter 9. To preach. And to meditate to keep thinking about it. It is like savoring. Divided hoof. That is to receive the word of God as given in both testaments, the old and the new. And Saint Irenaeus said, this is the faith. The belief in the Father and the Son. It is also refers to separating what is dead in us, that is crucifying the evil bodily lusts. And this is the real meaning of the cross, to crucify the lusts of the flesh. Aquatic creatures, they must have fins to assist in swimming and the scales to protect them. The fins refer to the means of grace that support the faithful in the midst of the world tides so that he may not be carried away unwillingly. Well, to be living fish. The living fish, it can swim against the current, against the wave. Not it is taken with the wave. We like ماشي مع التيار. The dead fish is carried by the current. السمكة الميتة هي اللي بيحملها التيار. You will find around us in the society that people are going away from God. But you go in the right direction. Not with the flow. the scales refer to the sin means that shield him from evil. Birds, those that are prohibited are the ones who prey. Prey eating other, eating flesh, meat. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Corpses, which are featured by snatching, attacking, devouring of corpses and the carcasses, similar to the law prohibiting us from viciousness, robbery, oppression, and the greed in our dealing with others. The eagle kiddo. Winged insects. In general, these are undesirable except for locusts. Are some people they like locusts? Yes, azure. Reptiles. All that crawls on its belly is considered unclean, symbolizing the person who is swallowed in errors, in earthly matters, and whose heart is incapable of rising to heavenly issues. God told the serpent to be in its belly and to eat from the earth. So those who are attracted to earth, they were swallowed by the serpent. These foods were symbolic, but are not profane in themselves, because the book of Acts, the vision of St. Peter before going to the centurion, the Roman centurion, Cornelius, he said to God, I didn't eat any unclean. So God told him, what God made it clean, don't say it is unclean. Saying apart the book of Acts. This is opening the gate for the Gentiles. When St. Peter went to the centurion Cornelius and started to talk with him about God, they received the Holy Spirit same as in Pentecost. And God did this at this time as exception. So nobody can blame St. Peter. Why did you go to Gentiles? Actually, they blamed him. They asked him, and he said it again and again. While I'm talking with them, they received the Holy Spirit same as it happened with us. The purification of women after childbirth. A lot of debate. 40 for the boys, 80 for the girls. We talked about it, do you remember? The purification of women after childbirth. Leviticus 12. Perhaps calling a woman unclean after childbirth, 40 days for a male child and 80 days for a female, was meant for her well-being, so that she refrains from all calls in order that she may look after herself. I like. It doesn't mean that this uncleanness because of sin, but to take care of herself. The 6 days for the purification of the mother are not sufficient for her to be considered pure. She is bound to present sacrifice of sin, to emphasize the fact that man is not capable of abolishing the sin or uncleanliness. The combination of two sacrifices together, burnt offering and the sin offering, refers to the mixture of our joy with attaining the forgiveness of our sins. in the joyful atmosphere of the newborn, this ritual draws the whole family to realize the sin's infiltration inside us through our ancestors. What is man that he could be pure, and he who is born of a woman that he could be righteous? من هو الإنسان حتى يزكو أو مولود المرأة حتى يتبرر؟ The Book of Job 15. Therefore, just as through one man sin entered the world and did it through sin, and thus this spread to all men because all sinned. What is the reference?
Romans.
You are right. Chapter. لا أقل لسه.
Is it Romans 6?
ولا أقل شوي ولا؟ طيب. How I know? Because I don't change the subject of Leviticus, but I want you to think about it. The Epistle to Romans, 16 chapters. Most of the epistles of St. Paul, two parts, doctrinal and practical. In Romans 1 to 11, doctrinal. 12 to 16, practical. The theme, the subject, the body of the epistle is God's righteousness. All of us, we need God's righteousness to be innocent, not guilty. Someone carried our sins, our Lord Jesus Christ. So the first three chapters, the need for righteousness. Because chapter one, Gentiles are sinners. Chapter two, Jews are sinners. Chapter 3, all are sinners. 4 and 5, examples of righteousness. 4, our father Abraham, 5, Adam. Is this why you know this is Adam? Through Adam comes sin. Through our Lord Jesus comes salvation. Life. This is why they consider our Lord Jesus the last Adam. And this is the contrast between the first Adam and the last Adam. I will explain it for you. And chapter 6, 7, and 8, fruits of righteousness. Free from sin, free from the law, and we become children of God. So this first Adam and sin, last Adam. Is this first Adam and last Adam? Second Adam. They said to him, our Lord Jesus, second Adam or last Adam?
Both.
St. Paul said it in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, the chapter of resurrection. Adam was a type of him who was to come. Adam was a type. Romans 5. Saint Justin the Martyr. He was martyred in 165 AD. He said that so that the disobedience caused by the serpent might be destroyed in the same way it had begun. Adam was created, not begotten. Our Lord was begotten, not created, because he is the creator. Adam was created in a supernatural way, from dust. Our Lord was incarnated in a supernatural way from the Virgin Saint Mary. this is, it is written by Saint Gregory of Nyssa. Saint Gregory of Nyssa was a bishop, the brother of Saint Basil the Great. Adam is without a mother or father. Our Lord without a mother or father. He is without father according to his humanity, and without a mother according to his divinity before the incarnation. Saint John Chrysostom says this. Saint Gregory of Nyssa, Saint Gregory the theologian, look to Saint John Chrysostom. The Son of God has no father and no mother, but how? Yes, he is without a father according to his earthly generation. Saint Mary gave birth to our Lord Jesus Christ without a father. And he was born from the Father before all ages, everlasting. He is without a mother according to his heavenly generation, Saint John Chrysostom. The first man, Adam, became a living being. Saint Paul says this, 1 Corinthians 15. The last Adam became a life-giving spirit. The first man was of the earth, made of dust. Last Adam, the second man, is the heavenly Lord. First Adam was created in the image of God. Last Adam, he is the image. What is the difference? In first Adam, in the image. Last Adam, he is the image. Do you know what is the difference? Original and the copy. He is the image of God. This is in the image of God. And this is with the reference, 2 Corinthians 4:4. And this is Genesis 1:26. First Adam was a man, and this is to make you to think that even two letters, it makes a big deal, a huge difference. So in theology, we should be very careful. Adam was a man who deserved to be like a God. Our Lord Jesus Christ, he is God, and he became a man. Philippians 2. Adam was proud. Our Lord was humble, emptied himself. And this is Philippians chapter 2, 5 to 11. And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death. Eve was created from Adam's side, and the church is found from second Adam's side, because from his side, because of the spear, it comes water and blood. This is to found the church. The foundation of the church. Water is baptism and the blood is the Holy Eucharist. This is by Saint Augustine. Saint Augustine said, when was Eve created? When Adam slept. When have the secrets of the church flowed from Christ's side? When he slept on the cross, when he died. If Christ joined himself to his church to become one body, how did he leave his father and mother? Because God said that the husband to leave, the groom to leave his father and mother. So Saint Augustine explained how our Lord Jesus Christ left the father and the mother. He left his father in the sense that he left his father, not that he forgot him or separated himself from him. but in his coming is the likeness of man. Now, how did he leave his mother? By leaving the synagogue of the Jews, from which he was begotten according to the flesh, to join the church that he assembled from all nations, son of Israel. First Adam disagreed and disobeyed when God told him not to eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Second Adam, our Lord Jesus, obeyed to the point of death, even the death of the cross split the answer. First Adam ate from the tree. Second Adam, they made from the tree a cross. He crucified on the tree. First Adam reached out and took the fruit. Second Adam reached out and they nailed his hand. First Adam savored the taste of the fruit, good for food. Second Adam, he drank vinegar, sour wine. First Adam, God called him, Adam, where are you? Second Adam, last Adam, our Lord Jesus on the cross, he said, my God, contrast. God said to Adam, in the sweat of your face you shall eat bread. Our Lord Jesus' sweat becomes like blood. The Gospel of St. Luke chapter 22. God said to Adam, cursed is the ground for your sake. Our Lord Jesus became a curse. Galatians 3. Our Lord Jesus redeemed us from the curse of the law and became cursed for our sake. God said to Adam that the earth will bring forth for him thorns and thistles. They took the thorns and they make it crown for our Lord Jesus Christ. First Adam, after he sinned, Adam was left naked. Our Lord was crucified naked to make us to put the garment of righteousness. First Adam sewed together fig leaves to make for himself a covering. Our Lord cursed the fig tree because it is a symbol of hypocrisy. Because fig leaves are not covering hypocrisy. A symbol of hypocrisy. First Adam, animals were sacrificed to cover Adam up with tunics of skin. Our Lord, our Passover, was sacrificed for us that he may clothe us with glory. This is by Saint Ephraim the Syrian. They call him the harp of the Holy Spirit. Eve looked for him, for the shame of woman was great. But he would be able to clothe them, not in leaves, but rather in the glory they had shed. Adam was tempted in the garden and he fell. Our Lord was tempted in the wilderness and he is victorious. The serpent caused Adam to fall. Our Lord Jesus crushed the head of the serpent. The cross, Saint Ephraim the Syrian, said the cross of Christ is swallowed up the serpent, which is swallowed Adam. The crucified Christ heals from the wound of the serpent. Saint Ephraim said, Aaron anticipated him. He who saw that if his staff is swallowed the reptiles in Egypt, his cross, the cross of our Lord, would swallow the reptiles that swallowed Adam and Eve. Very rhetoric. Amazing. they call it this by some different verses. Adam sinned. Our Lord Jesus Christ is without sin, committed no sin, nor was found in his mouth any deceit. And also was in all points tempted as we are, but without sin, Hebrews. For such a high priest, capital H, capital B, our Lord, who is fitting for us, who is holy, harmless, and defiled, separate from sinners, and has become higher than the heathens. For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us. الذي لم يعرف خطيئة صار خطيئة. That we might become the righteousness of God in him. 2 Corinthians chapter 5. And you know that he was manifested to take away our sins, and in him there is no sin. He knew no sin. Any of us, does anybody of us knows Japanese language? No one? So any Japanese vocabulary, it comes into our mind? No. This is the same with our Lord. He knew no sin. He knew no sin. Through Adam's sin, we knew death. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ we shall be made alive. Christ trampled the death with his death. O death, where is your sting? O Hades, where is your victory? Can you give me the reference?
2 Corinthians?
First Corinthians? Chapter 15? The chapter of resurrection. Adam was cast out of paradise. Our Lord Jesus opened the paradise when he said to the thief, "Assuredly, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." Look to the thief. God gave Adam and Eve dominion over nature. Man lost his authority because of sin. Our Lord Jesus Christ gave us authority again. He exercised the dominion over nature, fish, to be viewed, animals, birds, and he gave us authority. What Adam lost because of his disobedience, our Lord Jesus regained through his obedience. Hebrews 2:6. Adam was prevented from eating from the tree of life. Our Lord Jesus, he is the tree of life, and he gave us to eat from the tree of life according to the book of Revelation. To him who overcomes, I will give to eat from the tree of life, which is in the midst of the paradise of God, Revelation 2. Adam was created on the sixth day, Friday. Our Lord was crucified on the sixth day, Friday, to give us a new creation, to renew our creation. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. All the things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. 2 Corinthians chapter 5. The devil was conquered by his own trophy of victory, by seducing the first man, he slew him. By slaying the last man, he lost the first from his snare. I will tell you a story to understand it. Someone, they asked him, "Can you conquer the lion?" And he said, "Yes, I can conquer the lion." "How you will do it? You will do it like Samson or like David?" He said, no. I will let the lion to eat me. And after the lion ate me, I open his tummy. And I will take all the victims from his bed. So So through the envy of Satan comes the death. And our Lord, when he died, he took those who were in Hades waiting for his salvation. And this can't hold our Lord because he is life. He is the life. Saint Augustine said this. This is amazing. This is a letter. Is written about 125 AD, early second century. It said that our Lord Jesus Christ is a holy for the wicked, the innocent for the guilty, the just for the unjust, the incorruptible for the corruptible, the immortal for the mortal, the heavenly for the earthly, oh, the sweet exchange. Oh, the unexpected benefits. This letter to Diognetus, 125 AD. They say maybe this Diognetus was a governor. And someone, Christian, the author is unknown, wrote it to him. And we say it on the Gregorian liturgy, our Lord Jesus Christ descended to raise us up, was made poor to make us rich, became naked to clothe us, was wounded to heal us, died that we may live, thirst to quench us, hunger to fill us, was nailed, tied down to set us free, was sold to pay our debt, carried the cross to release us from our dirt. We are almost, St. Augustine said, as we have borne the image of the earthly, let us also bear the image of the heavenly. The heavenly became earthly, to make heavenly those who were earthly. From immortal he became mortal, to make immortal those who were mortal. The scholar Origen, if you remain in what is of the earth, you will be turned away in the end. You must be changed yourself, you must be converted. You must be made heavenly. Next time I will give you a printout of this God willing and glory to God forever. Amen.